Yes. So now we are going to study the different combinations in which you may get, and you may be asked in the given numerical how to solve this whole circuit, how to solve the complex circuit which is a system of so many capacitors, right? So we will learn step by step. 2 to 3 type of typical numericals come from this topic. So first of all, calculations is a second thing. Calculation is a secondary part. But first you should identify that in the given system, ये capacitor series में और ये वाले parallel में, and that is how I am going to solve the mixed combinations of capacitors in series and parallel. So two things you have to remember. The first, wherever the battery is connected, you will never ever start from that end. I repeat, wherever the end where the battery is connected, you will not start solving from that end. Second, whenever the charge is getting divided and lefts and rights are perfectly meeting, then we say that the capacitors are connected in parallel. अगर charge same जा रहा है पूरी branch में, charge divide नहीं हो रहा है, तो वो series में होंगे. और अगर कहीं पे भी charge divide हो रहा है और सारे lefts और सारे rights एक जगह पे मिल रहे हैं, then we consider they are in parallel. So we'll start solving the first one. Very simple, very basic. So ये battery है, battery से या cell source EMF कुछ भी कह दो, यहां से ये C1 C2 connected है, तो we will not start solving them. We will start solving the loop first. So इन दोनों को हम solve करेंगे. अब इन दोनों को अगर हम देखें, यहां से charge divide हो रहा है, right? And C4 C3 का right end perfectly meeting, left end perfectly meeting. तो C3 and C4 will be in parallel. Yes, C3 and C4 will be in parallel. Now the circuit looks like this. अभी सर्किट विल लुक लाइक दिस. C3 एंड C4 को सॉल्व करके ये हमने आंसर 1 निकाल लिया, राइट? नाउ C1, C2 एंड उन दोनों का जो आंसर 1 था, दीज 3, यहां से चार्ज गया, सेम चार्ज वापस आया, नो डिवीजन ऑफ चार्ज. सो दीज 3 विल बी इन सीरीज. वी अप्लाई द फॉर्मूला ऑफ पैरेलल फर्स्ट, देन वी अप्लाई द फॉर्मूला ऑफ सीरीज एंड वी सॉल्व इट लाइक दिस, राइट? प्रोसीडिंग टू द नेक्स्ट. C1, C2 and C3 आर कनेक्टेड इन सीरीज. चार्ज यहां से गया, C1 से गया, C2 से गया, C3 से गया, दे आर कनेक्टेड इन सीरीज. वेरी सिंपल. बट वॉट विल हैपन इफ आई कनेक्ट अ वायर बिटवीन दीज टू एंड्स, एंड इफ आई कनेक्ट अ वायर बिटवीन दीज टू एंड्स, वॉट विल हैपन नाउ, राइट? नाउ इफ यू लुक केयरफुली, the right part of C1, let us name this as right part, and the right part of C3, iska right iske right se mil raha hai. C3 ka left is meeting with left of C1. C1 or C3, C1 and C3 ke right and left se mil rahe hain. So it means C1 and C3 are connected in parallel. Now C2 comes in between them, between C1 and C3, it has to be in parallel. So these three, they look like as if they are connected in series, but actually they are in parallel. Simply, आपने एक वायर यहाँ पे लगाया और एक वायर यहाँ पे लगाया, then these three capacitors comes in parallel because the charge is getting divided from here. Charge is getting divided from here, and right ends and left ends are meeting. This comes in between, so it is also in parallel. So these three will be solved by the application of formula of parallel. Right? Now next, sometimes they will not give you the source नहीं दिया, तो जो भी open ends होंगे, we will assume कि यहाँ से एक battery connected है, virtual battery, और यहाँ से भी एक battery connected है. So wherever those two points are given, we need to assume that ये जो जो open points है ना, यहाँ से हम एक virtual battery मानेंगे हमेशा, wherever it is given. So in this question, right? I have not given any virtual points, I have not given any open points, because the answer would change, right? So how we will learn? Suppose I am giving you these points A and B here, right? So agar A or B yahan pe hai, to what I will consider? I will consider that A or B ke beech mein kya juda hai? A or B ke beech mein battery hai. I'll ask you calculate the capacitance between A and B. So, क्या मानना है आपको? आपको मानना है कि यहां से एक बैटरी और यहां से एक बैटरी जुड़ी. नाउ यू हाउ यू सॉल्व. सी वट एवर चार्ज विल कम फ्रॉम ए, सेम चार्ज इन C2, सेम चार्ज इन C3, सेम चार्ज इन C4. सो ये तीनों किसमें है? दीज थ्री आर कनेक्टेड इन सीरीज. after we solve them, after we solve this part, we get one answer. That one answer and this, right and left are meeting. So the answer of those three in series and this will be in parallel, right? Because the charge will get divided, right? Now suppose if I change the position of the battery, the answer would also change. अभी मैंने B point यहाँ पे नहीं लिया. Now I have taken B point here, right? How to solve now? अभी battery यहाँ पे और यहाँ पे connected है कहीं. Whatever charge battery is giving, same charge in C1, C4. ये दोनों किसमें? Series में. Same charge in C2, C3. ये दोनों भी किसमें? सीरीज में. एंड इफ दीज टू आर सॉल्व आंसर वन एंड दीज टू आर सॉल्व आंसर टू, दिस इज माई आंसर वन एंड दिस इज माई आंसर टू. नाउ हाउ आर दे कनेक्टेड? आंसर वन आंसर टू, दोज टू वर इन सीरीज. आंसर वन द बॉटम वन वर इन सीरीज, आंसर टू. नाउ आंसर वन एंड आंसर टू विल बी इन पैरेलल, राइट? बिकॉज द लेफ्ट एंड राइट आर मीटिंग एंड द चार्ज इज गेटिंग डिवाइडेड. I hope this is clear to you. Any doubts you may ask. Should we proceed to the complex ones? These were very easy ones. Nothing to solve in this. Not much to solve in this, right? So next one. If you look at next one, A and B battery यहाँ पे जुड़ी है. We will not start solving from C1, C5, C6. No. We will start solving from the farthest end from the battery. जहां पे भी जो छोटे छोटे loops है, we will solve them first. And then we will come towards the battery. So if you look here, यहां से जो भी charge जाएगा C2, C3 and C4, यहां से जो भी charge जाएगा C2 में, C3 और C4 में same charge गया, because there is no division, कोई joint नहीं है, charge कहीं पे भी divide नहीं हो रहा है. So C2, C3, C4 are connected in series. Same charge है, तो ये तीनों किसमें है? सीरीज में. वी विल सॉल्व मैथमेटिकली. सॉल्व करने के बाद सर्किट कुछ ऐसा दिखेगा. सिंप्लीफाइड सर्किट, दिस वुड लुक लाइक दिस. दिस इज आंसर वन, राइट? आंसर वन एंड C5, ये देखो यहां पे दोनों के लेफ्ट एंड्स, दोनों के राइट एंड्स, एंड चार्ज इज गेटिंग डिवाइडेड, एंड चार्ज इज गेटिंग डिवाइडेड. सो दीज टू विल बी इन पैरेलल, राइट? Answer 1 and C5 will be in parallel. After solving, the circuit look like this. Answer 2. Now how to solve now? Battery से जो भी charge गया वो यहां गया, answer 2 में गया और इसमें गया. So these three will be connected now in series again. Same charge will flow. जो charge यहां पे जाएगा वही charge overall loop के answer में जाएगा and same charge will flow through C3. So these three will be considered in series and we solve our question. Is that clear? Now this is a particular case, very very important particular case. Whenever five conductors are connected like this, अभी हमने पढ़ा ये तीनों देखो, say 1, 2, 3, they are connected in series. If I connect a wire from here and a wire from here, now they are connected in parallel. We have just now studied. But what if I connected a capacitor here and a capacitor here? This combination we need to understand. We'll study in current electricity chapter, but the application is here. This is point A, this is point B, is point ko humne naam de diya C, is point ko humne naam de diya D. Particular case. So let us say C1, C2, C3, C4, C5. C5. So let us assume end A, end B. A is connected to D through C1. I repeat, A is connected to point D through C1. Let us say A is connected to point D through C1. A is also connected to point C through C2. A is also connected to some point C through C2. Other end B is connected to C through C3. B is connected to C through C3. B is also connected to D through C4. B is also connected to D mutually connected by C5. Right? Now, this is a special case and this is called as Wheatstone Bridge. Wheatstone Bridge, that you will study in current electricity. What is a Wheatstone Bridge? Wheatstone Bridge is a perfect combination of 5 resistors in such a way that 2 resistors are in bridge form above, 2 resistors are in bridge form below, and there is a vertical arm. Ye arm battery se nahi connect hogi. There is a vertical arm in which resistance C5 is there, such that is point ka potential and is point ka potential same hai. I repeat, Wheatstone Bridge is a combination of 5 resistors in such a way that 2 resistors are above in bridge form, 2 resistors are below in bridge form, and there is a vertical arm with a resistor such that ye wale point ka aur ye wale point ka potential same hai. When potential is same, no charge will flow. Potential same, charge flows from higher potential to lower potential. अभी अगर इस पॉइंट का और इस पॉइंट का पोटेंशियल सेम है तो हम क्या कंसीडर करेंगे? हम कंसीडर करेंगे कि ये C5 कोई भी चार्ज कैरी नहीं कर रहा. जब ये C5 कोई भी चार्ज कैरी नहीं कर रहा, यहाँ पे कोई चार्ज फ्लो ही नहीं हो रहा, तो व्हाट वी विल डू, वी विल इग्नोर दिस आर्म. वी विल इग्नोर दिस आर्म एंड दैट इज हाउ द सर्किट लुक लाइक. बैटरी यहाँ पे कनेक्टेड है, सेम चार्ज इन दोनों में, दीज टू इन सीरीज, सेम चार्ज इन दोनों में, दीज टू इन सीरीज. आंसर वन आंसर टू लुक लाइक दिस. आंसर वन आंसर टू, यहाँ पे है ए, यहाँ पे है बी. इन दोनों को सॉल्व करके CS1 सीरीज में, इन दोनों को सॉल्व करके CS2 सीरीज में. राइट, नाउ CS1 एंड CS2 आर इन पैरेलल. सो दैट इज हाउ वी सॉल्व Wheatstone Bridge अरेंजमेंट. सो लुकिंग एट दिस यू विल सिंप्लीफाई द सर्किट, यू विल आइडेंटिफाई दोज टू पॉइंट्स. And then you will solve these two in series, and finally in parallel, right? The balance condition of Wheatstone Bridge says this ratio should be equal to this ratio. You will study it properly in second chapter. So balancing condition not required. You will ignore this, that you have to see. आप इसको तभी इग्नोर कर सकते हो जब इन दोनों का रेशियो C2/C1 is equals to C3/C4. अगर ये बैलेंस है, अगर इन दोनों का रेशियो या इन दोनों का रेशियो, देखो C2/C3 भी लिख सकते हैं इधर, C2/C3 ऑल्सो कैन बी रिटन. ये दोनों रेशियो इज इक्वल टू ये दोनों रेशियो और दीज टू रेशियो इज इक्वल टू दीज टू रेशियो, देन यू मे कंसीडर कि इन दो पॉइंट्स का पोटेंशियल सेम है और इसको हम इग्नोर कर सकते हैं. अगर ये रेशियो सेम नहीं है, देन वी कैन नॉट अप्लाई Wheatstone Bridge. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, yes, for example, can I ignore this? This is say 10, say this is 5. Can I ignore this? How will I check whether I can ignore or not? 2/4 is 1/2, 4/8 is 1/2. दोनों का रेशियो सेम है तो आई कैन इग्नोर दिस, अदरवाइज आई कैन नॉट. अगर ये यहाँ पे 4 की जगह 9 होता, देन आई कैन नॉट अप्लाई Wheatstone Bridge बिकॉज इट इज नॉट बैलेंस्ड. If it is 4, then I can apply and I can ignore. 10 वाला नहीं करंट कैरी करेगा. अगर ये रेशियो सेम है, इसका मतलब ये पॉइंट और ये पॉइंट का पोटेंशियल भी सेम है, then we can ignore the fifth one. Clear children? One more thing, आप ऐसे भी रेशियो चेक कर सकते हो और आप ऐसे भी रेशियो चेक कर सकते हो. ये देखो 2:4 is 1/2, 4:8 is also 1/2. So either check this ratio or check this ratio. If this ratio is same, then that ratio obviously will be the same. And then we can ignore the fifth one. Can we ignore here? Is it a Wheatstone Bridge arrangement? Please check and tell me. Can I ignore this 5 or not? Yes, we can ignore. Why? Because 1/3 is equals to 2/6 or 1:2 का रेशियो जो है वही 3:6 का रेशियो है. सो हम इसको इग्नोर कर देंगे. एंड व्हेन वी इग्नोर दिस, इट मींस these two in series, answer one, these two in series, answer two, answer one and answer two in parallel. So that is how you can solve the Wheatstone bridge arrangement. कोई explanation नहीं देना. Say it is following Wheatstone bridge. सिर्फ ये check करें कि ये दोनों ratio, ये दोनों ratio और ये दोनों ratio और ये दोनों ratio same है या नहीं. Then you can apply directly Wheatstone bridge. Right children? And the last one, proceeding to the last one. So this is a bit complex circuit, but जितना भी complex circuit कोई होता है उसका solution उतना ही easy होता है. It looks complex, but it is very simple. You'll understand. Right, so battery is connected here, so we will not start solving from here, we will solve from the farthest loop. Right, so if you see this point, let us say P Q R S, P point ko dekho, Q point ko dekho, yahan se jo charge ja raha hai 3 and 4 mein same ja raha hai, 3 and 4 ye dono kis mein, series mein, simplify, ye aa gaya hamara answer 1. Answer 1. Now, answer 1 and 8 are in parallel. Answer 1 and 8, left end mile hai, right ends mile hai. Charge divide ho raha hai. So, these two are in parallel. Answer 2. Answer 2 looks like this. Answer 2. Right? Now, answer 2 and 5. Same charge yahan tak ja raha hai. No charge division. Answer 2 and 5 in series, right? Solving, we get answer 3. Circuit simplify ho gaya and answer 3. This is how the circuit look like. Right, now you may continue. Same procedure. These two in parallel. Yahan pe jo bhi answer aayega, wo iske saath series mein. Finally, parallel, then parallel, series, and that is how we will solve step by step. Loop by loop, we will solve. Right, and we will get the answer. I hope you understand all these types.